Good evening once again. So this is our second night of our reflection. And focus of our reflection tonight is family love, sharing the death of our Lord. Medyo nakakatakot na topic, no? Kahapon, sharing the passion of Jesus, at least bearable yung passion, suffering, sacrifices, but paano na to? Sharing the death of Jesus or uniting ourselves with the death of Jesus. You know, there is a saying that goes like this. The measure of love is to love without measure. Before finalizing this reflection, I was trying to look for the original version of this, because I know it was a saint who said this. The measure of love is to love without measure. And I was surprised that there are many saints actually who made this quotation. And first was Saint Augustine. The measure of love is to love without measuring. Parang ganon. Then Saint Bernard of Clairvaux also said that to love without measure is the measure of loving. And also Saint Francis de Sales. So there are many saints. That's why it's so beautiful to remind us that loving is the greatest virtue of a Christian. But how do you connect this virtue of loving in the passion of the Lord? Of course, it's very connected. Why? Because in John chapter 15, verse 13, the Lord said, "There is no greater love than to lay down one's life for one's friends." Wow. And then the Lord said, "I called you friends. All of us are friends of Jesus. That's why He laid down on the cross as the greatest expression of loving. Binigay niya ang kanyang buhay para sa ating lahat. And that is the measure of love." I am a bit surprised, because there's a song that is so popular. It was not a very recent song, but I think it is in 1980s perhaps, or 1990s. And the line of the song goes like this. I believe all of you are familiar with this song. "Learning to love yourself is the greatest love of all." Who sang that song? Who sang that song? I think Whitney Houston. "Learning to love yourself is the greatest love of all." Many tend to believe that that is the greatest love of all. But that is not. Yes, to love the self, because we cannot give what we do not have. You have to love yourself. That is very basic. But the greatest love of all is, according to Jesus, "There is no greater love than to lay down one's life for one's friends." And the measure of love is the cross, the crucifixion of Jesus. That is to love without measure. Giving up His life so that all of us will live. Can you find greater love than that? You know, you can make a sacrifice for a good person. But can you make a sacrifice for a bad person? Can anyone here make a sacrifice for a rapist? For a criminal? It's so difficult, I think. No one would dare to do that. But look at Jesus. When all of us were sinners, and are sinners even up to now, the Lord offered His life as the best offering, as the best gift, so that all of us will live with Him in heaven for eternity. And that is why the measure of love is like Jesus. Self-offering love. Self-giving love. marami pong nagka-problema sa mag-asawa. In my counseling with some of the couples who approached me and asked me to guide them, bakit nagka-problema sila sa kanilang relasyon? Because one of them tend to become selfish. Yung kaligayahan ko lang. Even among siblings, bakit may siblings rivalry? Bakit minsan nag-away ang mga magulang at mga anak? It boils down to, of course, misunderstanding. Why misunderstanding? Naging minsan selfish yung isa. And that is why looking at the example of Jesus, no greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends, is the best example that is given to us that we can only live harmoniously if we have this selfless loving. Hindi po yung selfish loving. Diyan pong magka-problema, doon tayo magka-problema pag selfish loving. Kasi nauna ang kaligayahan. Pero ang pagmamahal ni Jesus, no greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. Selfless giving. Selfless loving. You know, I remember the words in the Theology of the Body of St. John Paul II. And there's a series of lectures from 1979 to 1983 in Rome when he was still alive and the Pope of the Universal Church. And he said that conjugal love is donation. Oh, yung ganda ng paggamit niya, no? Yung married love, family love, is self-donation. You are a gift to the other. If husband looks at the wife as a gift, and so he would give himself as a gift to the wife, and vice versa, and then the parents to children, and the siblings among themselves also, love one another, in that kind of self-donating love, inuuna yung kaligayahan ng isa, ng kanyang family member kaysa kanya. And we could have avoided many misunderstandings and quarrels and conflicts in the family. That is why it's very important to bear in mind that what kind of love that really sanctifies family life. It is the love of Jesus that is selfless loving. Self-giving love. And if we are going to look at that, no, even Pope Francis reminds us that in family life, we must not be afraid to embrace those moments of pain, those moments of problems and difficulties. Because in those moments, let us try to encounter Jesus there. No, even in down moments, pag may problema tayo sa ating pamilya, if you only look at the crucified Jesus, nandiyan sa likuran, no? Crucified Jesus. You know, that can lighten your burden. Because you will be reminded of that someone, the purity of His love, and that person hanging on the cross, the person of Jesus, somehow reveals also our own commitment to life. Kahit mahirap, Lord, ituloy ko ang laban. Laban lang. Minsan, we heard it from the sports-minded individuals. Pag yung gilas, no, nagbabasketball, nahirapan na sila kasi matatangkad ang mga kalaban at mga magagaling. Laban lang, laban, puso, puso. Tayong lahat may puso. At anong maganda pa doon, yung puso natin ay naging pattern after the puso ni Kristo, yung pagmamahal natin. And that would, of course, facilitate our relationship so much. If we know how to love like Jesus. I remember a story in relation to this selfless loving. Maybe you are familiar with the story, and it's just a kind of in my own version. So one day, there were people andun po sa isang wharf, naglakad-lakad sila. May mag-ina, accidentally nahulog ang bata sa tubig, sa dagat. So the mother was in panic and she was shouting, "Oh, my son fell to the water. Please, please help my daughter. Please help my daughter. Anybody, please. Saklolo." Then after a while, after a few seconds, someone jumped into the water and then he saved the life of a child. Binigay niya doon sa nanay. Naku, nangyari doon, yung mga tao, pinuntahan siya, pinasalamatan siya. Pati na yung, siyempre, yung nanay. Sabi, "Salamat. At least you are a good Samaritan. Mayroon pa palang good Samaritan ngayon. You're a hero. Thank you so much for saving the life of my daughter." Ano niyo bang nangyari? Yung nag-save sa bata, tingin ng tingin. He was not concentrated on what the appreciation of the people. He was tingin ng tingin. Sabi naman to, "Ano pong tinitingnan nyo? Kayo po hero. Naging bayani today." Sabi ng mama, "Tinitingnan ko kasi kung sino yung tumulak sa akin sa tubig. Who pushed me to the water? I was forced to save the child because someone pushed me down into the water." Brothers and sisters, it may be a familiar story, but I hope that in the family love, you are not forced to love. Why? What are the important elements of loving? Free love. Yan po ang pagmamahal ni Kristo. Yan po yung tinatawag na gratuitous love. Nagmamahal ng libre. True love is free. Yan po ang pagmamahal ng Diyos. When He loves us, He does not make us slaves, but His friends. Yan po ang family love. Yes, embracing the passion and death of the Lord. But that begins within us. The willingness to donate ourselves for the good of the other. Pag yun po ang iniisip ng bawat isa, kahit na dito sa MU, no? Pag yung teachers, mga students, mga workers, lahat nag-iisip, ano kayang nakakabuti sa marami? What can promote the common good of this institution? If each one is thinking along that line, then I think this university will grow, will develop in a proportion beyond imagination. Yun ang iisip. Kaya nga yung pamilya, if they are really thinking of what is good of one another, then that family is a happy family. Bakit ba may mga pamilya na malungkot ang family member? Nagiging greedy, nagiging proud yung iba, nagiging selfish, inuna ang sariling kaligayahan. Kaya nga, the secret of a happy family life is selfless loving, free loving, self-donation, self-giving love. I know it's easier said than done, but we have the person up there, our Lord Jesus Christ, embracing the cross freely for love of us. Alam ko naman na mahirap talagang magiging martyr. That is a gift. Yung mga unang saints natin, kanunay saints are martyrs, no? Saint Lorenzo Ruiz, Saint Pedro Calungsod. Yung iba, you know, sabi nila, "Father, hindi na panahon ngayon ng mga martyrs. Panahon na ngayon ng mga wise." Wise. But you know, in the Christian life, what is a truly wise life? A truly wise person? A person who lives in love. A person who is loving like Jesus. The measure of love is to love without measure, because Jesus loves us unconditionally. Yes, mahirap po ang magmahal. Mas maganda na tayo'y minamahal. No? Di ba? But in order to experience love, you must love first. You must know how to love. I remember the words of Kiara Lubich, the foundress of Focolare movement, because I had a chance when I was a seminarian to go to Tagaytay and attend a school, no? School of life, like that. I was amazed, no, by that kind of simplicity of life. Yung communion of goods. And then even telling us, look each one like Jesus. See Jesus in every person. Ako, mahirap yun. Kasi kagalit ko yan. How can I love this person? Diba? Sa mundo ngayon, lalo na ngayon, no? May conflict, maraming gera, and we are threatened, no, by this war between Russia and Ukraine, and we experience now the crisis of the rising prices of fuel and commodities, no, as an effect of that, one of the effects. And so the Pope is calling for the truce, no, that sana ngayong Easter may totoong truce between Russia and Ukraine. Hindi lang yung truce na iwan yung armas para mag-gather ng marami pang armas and babalik na naman sa gera. Yun sinasabi niya. Sabi niya, totoong truce, lay down. Yes, we cannot lay down our life. We cannot just die literally, but lay down the arms. Lay down the conflicts in the family. Lay down your angers to one another. Lay down your pride, so that family love will prevail in the home. So that family love will prevail in the university. Lay down the selfishness, the greed in your life. Allow the love of Jesus to prevail in your life. And you know, that is the reign of God. That is the kingdom of God. You know, family love is also allowing the kingdom of God to reign in the family. And what is the kingdom of God? You know, some people said that, yung kingdom of God, heaven is up there and hell is down there. No, the kingdom of God is a state of life. Paano natin sinasabuhay ang mga salita ng Diyos, ang mga values ni Kristo diyan sa ating pamilya, sa ating workplace, sa ating university? Paano natin sinasabuhay yun? Living out of love because of love. The kingdom of God is what is the characteristic of the love of God, or the kingdom of God? Allowing the basileia, the reign of God, to rule in our hearts. Kasi yung kingdom comes from the Greek word basileia. Basileia is translated in English as reign. The rule of Jesus. And what is the rule, the reign of God? Love. That is the new commandment. All other virtues will be gone. Only love remains in heaven. And you know, brothers and sisters, if you live in love, then you are assured of God's presence. Wherever you are, you're always an instrument of God. You are always peace bringers. You're always reconcilers. If you always live in love, then you always bring joy to the others, because inuna nyo ang kaligayahan ng iba, hindi ang sarili. That is the secret of love. According to one priest, what is the secret of love? It's not to look for your own happiness. The secret of love is that you have someone to love, that you have a goal, that you know the direction of your life. Be the first one to love. According to Kiara Lubick, love is always reciprocal. Paano yan, Father? Matagal na po ako na hindi nakaranas ng pagmamahal. God will reciprocate you the other ways. Just live in love. That is our identity as Christians. Family love, united to the death of Jesus, is to love unconditionally like God. To love without measure. To love selflessly. To love without expecting something in return. Allow me to give you guide questions for your reflection as we are about to end this second topic. The first one is this. Are we willing to die to selfishness so that family love and family relationship and relationship with our neighbor will blossom? Diba? Gusto din natin, diba, na gaganda ang buhay. Gaganda ang relasyon. But are you willing to let go of your selfish love so that the love of God prevails in your heart and in your family and in your workplace? Second guide question, am I capable of self-donation for love of God and family and neighbor? Yung self-donation, of course, you're gonna say, okay, I will donate myself to you. It's not literally, no? But what I'm saying is, selfless loving, na handa mong ibigay ang panahon. Handa mong ibigay ang mayroon kayong mga values na i-share sa iba for the sake of the love of God. Self-donating love. Self-giving love like our Lord. And that is why it's very important to be reminded also of the saying of Mother Teresa of Calcutta, which I think all of you are familiar with. And she said, I have found a paradox that if you love until it hurts, there can be no more hurt, only more love. Wow. If you love till it hurts, then you discover that there will be no more hurts, but only love in your heart. That is the love of Jesus. No greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. Be the first one to love and love like Jesus. Good evening po. Maraming salamat.